Hi! We're on the Breadcrumbs tab of the search appearance settings of Yoast SEO. In this screencast, I'll explain what breadcrumbs are, how you can enable them on your site, and how you can customize them to your liking. First of all, let me explain why breadcrumbs are on the search appearance on Yoast SEO and why we would be bothering ourselves with breadcrumbs. You're probably familiar with how they look, as they show up on every well-structured site. This is an example. Breadcrumbs show visitors how one page fits into the structure of your site. You can click the larger categories this page belongs to, like SEO training, and you can always find the homepage at the beginning of the path. And this is very convenient for your visitors, as breadcrumbs help them navigate your site more easily. So, your visitors like breadcrumbs. But Google does too. Breadcrumbs give Google another way of figuring out how your website is structured. And Google may also use your breadcrumbs in the actual search results, which makes your result more enticing to users. For example, you can see here that for the page I just showed you, you see SEO training here, instead of seeing the entire URL of the page. Every site that has breadcrumbs like that will have results like this, instead of showing the entire URL. Now, then tell me, how can I get these super convenient breadcrumbs? Well, to work with our Yoast SEO breadcrumbs, you have to do two things. You have to make sure that your theme supports our breadcrumbs, and you have to enable them in the search appearance settings right here. Most themes support our breadcrumbs, but if yours doesn't, you can ask your theme author or your developer to implement them. If you click this link, you'll find a complete guide on how to do this. You can also do it yourself, but therefore you need to know how to implement code. When you enable them here, you can determine a lot of different settings. You can choose a separator, you can say what the homepage should be called, you can say, hey, I want this text to show up before all my breadcrumbs, for example, you are here. And of course, you can also change the other prefixes over here. And with this option, you can determine whether the last page in the breadcrumbs should be bold or regular. These settings are all fairly easy to grasp and manage. The last section of this page is a little more advanced. If you click this drop-down menu here, you can select category, tag, or format. These are all taxonomies, and taxonomies group content. For example, if you write posts about poodles, chihuahuas, and labradors, you could group them in a category called dogs. Now, if you want that category to show up in the breadcrumbs as well, you can take care of that with this setting. Just select category, and then you'll see both the category, dogs, and the name of the post, for example, how to trim poodles, in the breadcrumb path. If you have more custom content types that allow for breadcrumbs, they will show up below posts. And if you have more custom taxonomies, they will show up in the drop-down menu. And they will also show up below the heading of the next setting over here. The next heading is a little more abstract. Here you can select which content type archive you want to show in your breadcrumbs for taxonomies. Now let's explore what that means. If you don't have custom content types, and you don't have a static page for your blog posts, you could skip this part, because your drop-down menus will be empty. There's nothing to choose. If you don't have custom content types, but you do have a static page for your blog post, you can select the blog option in the menu. Now let's quickly create a static page to show you what I mean. Now, if we go back to the breadcrumb settings, you'll see that we now can select blog in the drop-down menu. If you select blog for your categories, the static page with all your blog posts will be visible in your breadcrumbs when you're on a category page. Your breadcrumbs path could be something like homepage, blog, dogs, for example. By the way, as soon as you create a static page for your blog posts, another switch will appear in the breadcrumb settings as well. You will find it over here. You can toggle between show and hide. If you choose to show your blog page, it will be visible in your breadcrumbs. Okay, back to the previous setting we were talking about. If you have custom content types, like movies, books, or courses, these will appear in the drop-down menu. Now you can select which content type archive, so all your movies or all your posts, you want to show in your breadcrumbs for your taxonomy pages. Theoretically speaking, every match is possible. If you want to show your post archive when you're on a movie category page, you could. Think about what makes sense for your site. Good luck!